I think I'm still kind of in the, I'm going to wake up and this is going to be a bad dream.
For years, these pictures captured images of serenity, of love, of peace, from inside the fences of pastures which back up to the Muddy Creek Greenway in Winston-Salem.
Knowing that there's people and children all over the place there, that's scary.
But today, those have transitioned to snapshots of remembrance, a stone painted reading RIP across along a fence line and flowers pinned amongst the wire.
You know, it broke my heart, you know, because you know the horses realize that she's gone.
Saturday morning around 7:40, the fence line was littered with shell casings as several shots echoed amongst the fields and Jelly, seen here, was killed.
He said that there'd been a shooting, which of course made my heart stop.
Kay Johnson's horse, Dixie.
They were best friends.
Was shot too, as was another couple's horse, Cisco.
In the first several days after Jelly died, Dixie would just call and call and call.
Police say these three vehicles, an Impala, a yellow truck, and a black Bronco, are all believed to be connected to the shootings. All three have now been recovered, with the Bronco and the truck being found Tuesday.
There's houses all around, the two schools, playgrounds, which makes the shooting that much scarier.
Tonight, Cisco's injuries are being considered minor. Dixie, as you can see here, still has pellets lodged inside of her, but should be okay.
From her chin all the way back across her right side and down under her belly, were just lumps.
And as the people who put them there continue to roam free, Jelly's body will spend eternity here, next to the cross which bears her name.
These people just don't care about anything.
In Winston-Salem, Michael Hennessy, Fox 8 News.